And she died, going into Jannah. والسابقون السابقون, those who beat us, my dear brothers and sisters. What were they like? They sacrificed their wealth. Their wealth, my dear brothers, they sacrificed their wealth for Jannah. How? How can you buy this world with your money and sell the hereafter for a few pennies or a few dollars which you can earn in this life? Why? How? How could you buy this worthless life when the Prophet ﷺ said, "Ad-dunya, this whole world, وَمَا فِيهَا لَا تُسَاوِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَاحَ بَعُوضَةً." It is not worth a wing of a mosquito to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَوْ كَانَتْ تُسَاوِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَاحَ بَعُوضَةً. If it were to be worth the wing of a mosquito, لَمَا سَقَ اللَّهُ مِنْهَا الْكَافِرُ شُرْبَةَ مَاءً. Allah would have never let the one who rejects him drink a drop of its water, if it was worth the wing of a mosquito. And there are a lot of Muslims who place the world on their head like a crown. When the companions used to place the world in their hands and their religion like a crown. If what is in their, if their crown went out of place, they would put what was in their hands on the ground. So the hereafter was on their head, and when it went out of place, they dropped the dunya and they fixed their religion. Today it's the opposite, my dear brothers and sisters. Today it's the opposite. They sacrificed their wealth. There was a time, my dear brothers and sisters, a story of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and Umar. Umar radiallahu anhu used to always try to beat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, because this was their quality. They always were jealous of each other when someone did better good deeds. Not jealous of each other when someone had more money or beauty or a voice or whatever. And they would love each other and try to beat each other for that. So one day the Muslims were in need and they were in great poverty, and the Prophet ﷺ called the Muslims to bring what they have of wealth if they are able to do so. So Umar radiallahu anhu said, "Today wallahi I'm going to beat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu." So he went to his house and he said, "I'm going to take half of everything that I have in my house." And so even the earrings, he took one earring and left another earring for his wife. His wealth, he split it in half, everything. And he held a large baggage on top of his shoulder and he walked with them. On his way he saw Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and he was only carrying a small amount. And he said, "Alhamdulillah, today I have beaten him." Yes, this is how they raced each other. When they reached the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Umar radiallahu anhu, "What have you left for your family? Have you looked after them?" He said, "Yes, Ya Rasulullah, I've left half of my wealth." He said, "Barakallahu fika Ya Umar." Then he turned to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and he said, "What have you left for your family, Abu Bakr? You have brought a very small amount." He said, "Taraktu lahum Allahu wa Rasuluh." He said, "I left for them Allah and His Messenger." I left for them Allah and His Messenger. He left nothing but Allah and His Messenger. They will look after them. Subhanallah. And that's when Umar ibn Khattab said, "Ya laytani, I wish that I were a hair on the chest of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu." La ilaha illallah. What about Mus'ab ibn Umair, who resembled the Prophet ﷺ in his appearance and character, who the Prophet ﷺ looked at him and knew that he has a beautiful tongue, so he sent him to Medina. He was the one who went to Medina, and when the Prophet ﷺ migrated from Mecca to Medina, he found 88,000 people from Medina that were singing Tala al-Badru alayna min thaniyat al-wada'. Where did they come from? From Mus'ab ibn Umair radiallahu anhu. Before Islam, he was the wealthiest. Before Islam, he was the most handsomest. Before Islam, he used to look after himself, that he used to put so much cologne and would look after himself so much that the women of Mecca, when they smelt his perfume, they would stand in a line to wait for him to pass, wanting to attract him. Yes, this was Mus'ab ibn Umair radiallahu anhu. When he embraced Islam, he donated everything he had of his wealth in the cause of those who were more in need. And then in the battle of Uhud, Mus'ab ibn Umair, fighting like a lion, defending the Muslims, defending the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when a spear attacked him, it struck him, and then swords one by one, until he had over 70 stabbings, and he fell to the ground. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions, after the battle was over, he came to bury the Muslimin, the Mujahideen, the Shuhada. And then when they looked at Mus'ab ibn Umair, they searched through his wealth and he did not find anything with his wealth to cover him. All they could find in his house was a piece of cloth to wrap him up in, the kafan. And when they would cover his head, his feet would show. And when they would cover his feet, his head would show. And the Prophet ﷺ said, "Bakhim bakh ya Mus'ab ibn Umair. Oh Mus'ab ibn Umair, We did not find anything of the wealth just to cover your whole body and bury you in. You donated it all for those who were in need. فَالْجَنَّةُ هِيَ اللِّقَاءِ. In Jannah is where we shall meet. الفردوس الأعلى, my dear brothers and sisters. And many, many more of them. Brothers and sisters, their love for paradise made them do the most amazing things. They made them honorable and kings and the most wealthiest, even though in money they didn't have much. They were kings even though they did not wear crowns and cloaks made of silk and wool of the most expensive type. They were kings and honorable and happy even though they did not have what normal people anticipate for and think of it to be happiness. Naam, their sadness disappeared when they knew their lost ones made it to paradise. If someone died from their family, it was enough for them, for their sadness to go away when they knew that they had ended up in paradise. This is the story of Haritha radiallahu anhu. Haritha radiallahu anhu and his mother Ummu Haritha. He wanted to go out one time with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also in one of the battles. And remember, my brothers and sisters, the Muslims never fought a battle when they started it. They only fought battles after the enemies had taken and driven them out of their lands and massacred their children and raped their women. Haritha radiallahu anhu, between the age of 20 and 25, he came with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to go out into jihad for the first time. And his mother had prepared him to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then when they went out, my dear brothers and sisters, the Muslimin arrived to a certain place where there was a well. A well, and one of the where there was a well. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to one of the Sahaba to go and protect that well at night when the Muslims are asleep, so that no one can come to that well and take it over from the enemies. And then in the middle of the night, when the Sahaba was protecting that well, all of a sudden Haritha woke up. He woke up to go to the well to drink because he was extremely thirsty when he was asleep. And then when he reached the cliff, he was about to go down into the well. This Sahaba, he looked up into the cliff and he thought it was one of the enemies coming to take over the well. And so he armed his arrow and targeted towards him. And then he speared him. And the arrow struck Haritha radiallahu anhu right in his chest. And then he fell to the ground. And then this Sahaba raced towards him in order to see who it was. And then, to his sadness and sorrow and to his shock, he found that it was Haritha radiallahu anhu. A Muslim had mistakenly killed another Muslim. And as Haritha was dying, he said, La ilaha illallah. And his soul escaped from his body. The Muslims found out the story. And they went and they had their battle. And then they returned back to the Muslimin. And then Ummu Haritha came along, his mother, searching for her son. When she saw all the soldiers returning back, she would look at that person and look at this person to see if it was Haritha. But every time she went from one companion to another, it was someone else. And then she grabbed one of the companions and she said to him, my son, where is my son? Is he a shaheed? Is he a martyr? Was he killed in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And then the companions would say, your son Haritha, no, he wasn't in the battle. He wasn't in the front lines. No, he wasn't killed. Shaheed, I don't think he is a shaheed. And she began to cry and scream. And she said, show me where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is. And when she found him, she grabbed the Prophet, she came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she said to him, Ya Rasulullah, qulli, tell me, my son Haritha, is he in Jannah? Is he in Jannah? Or is he not? Wallahi, if you tell me that he is not in Jannah, you will see what I'm going to do. I'm going to turn this world upside down. This is what a mother feels, ya akhwan. Yes, a mother who understands Jannah and paradise, she wants her son to reach the highest place. But of course, in a worthy cause. Ya Rasulullah, tell me. And if he is not in paradise, you will see what I will do. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at her and he yelled and he said, Ya Ummu Haritha, ahabilti, ahabilti ya Ummu Haritha. Have you gone mad, ya Ummu Haritha? Have you lost your mind? Inna Haritha qad mata shaheedan wa inna Haritha qad asaba al-firdaws al-a'la. Innaha jinan wa inna Haritha fil firdaws al-a'la. He said, are you crazy, ya Ummu Haritha? Haritha died, a martyr in Islam, and he is not only in Jannah, it is many Jannat, it is many paradises, and he has targeted the highest place in Al-Firdaws Al-A'la. Now, because he died with a sincere and proper intention. this, my dear brothers and sisters, they sacrificed their lusts and their temptations also in love for paradise. This is another story of a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a young boy at the age of about 16 or 17. His name is Tha'labah radiyallahu anhu. Tha'labah radiyallahu anhu was one of the active youth in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who obeyed the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and his heart was firm in the belief of the Quran, and he was completely convinced in the existence of Allah, and he anticipated and sacrificed everything to reach Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once sent Tha'labah on an errand, meaning he sent him to do something, and then Tha'labah went. It only would have taken him half a day to complete this errand. When on his way, Tha'labah was on his way back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he reached close to Medina and he was passing by a small village which was built of small tents, and then he heard one of the tents as though there was water being spilt inside, like a shower, as though there was someone bathing in there. Tha'labah did not have the right to open that tent and to look who was inside of there. However, his lust, his hormones played up a bit at that time, and the shaitan deluded him into opening a tiny crack in that tent. And he looked inside and accidentally, to his shock, saw a naked woman bathing. As his temptations and lusts and hormones began to rise, he remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he closed the tent and he screamed so high and so, he yelled so loud that he said, "Man ladhi qad fa'altu? What have I done? La ilaha illallah. Allah will now send a verse down to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that I am one of the hypocrites." Because at that time the Quran was being sent down. He said, "Wallahi la yadhkurni la yadhkurni Allahu ma'al munafiqin." Allah is now going to mention me one of the hypocrites. How could I worship Allah and then go and look into to see a naked woman in her tent? How can I say that I am a mu'min? Allah is surely going to say that I am one of the hypocrites. سَيَذْكُرَنِ اللَّهُ مَعَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. And he forgot all about returning back to the Prophet ﷺ, who was too scared. He did not want to hear anything, because it was almost certain that there was a verse sent down in the name of Tha'labah. He is a munafiq. So instead of going to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he ran away and he headed towards the cliffs and he stayed up there. When he didn't return to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet began to become worried and he said, "Where is Tha'labah? I hope nothing has happened to him." The next day came and Tha'labah hadn't returned. So he sent his companions outside to look for him, and when they went and they tried and they returned, they said, "Ya Rasulullah, we don't know where he is." And they kept the search going for about a week, until finally the Prophet ﷺ sent Abu Bakr and Umar for a special task to look for him and find him. He said, "Go, look out into the outskirts of Medina, into the cliffs and the hills, into the forests and in the trees. Search every tent, ask anyone that you see, and search for Tha'labah. I'm very worried about Tha'labah." And so they went out, and it took them weeks to search for him, until finally they approached this village where they found a shepherd with his goats. And they approached him and said, "Have you seen a young man? His descriptions are so and so. He is of this height and his name is Tha'labah." He said, "Are you asking about the crying boy?" They said, "What crying boy?" He said, "The boy that weeps a lot. There is a young boy that sits up in those cliffs over there. Our village hears him every night crying, and we don't know what his matter is. Every day he comes down and he drinks a bit of milk from my goats, and then he would drag himself back up into the mountains." And they said, "This is surely Tha'labah." So Abu Bakr and Umar went up to the mountain and they searched for him until they found him, sheltered.